You can see the pause menu opening in two different ways here. Which one do you find more impressive? In this video, we will learn how to use Lean Tune Asset. Tuning, short for in between, is a technique used to create intermediate frames of animation between two keyframes, allowing for seamless transitions and smooth motion. For example, if you want to scale up an object, you can smoothly bring it to its final scale over a predetermined time using Lean Tune. With Lean Tune, you can animate position, rotation, scale, color, and other properties of game objects. We should especially do UI animations with tuning, because it's simpler and more performance to use than Unity animation. Okay, let's learn how to use Lean Tune. Let's look at the sample scene. On the scene, there is a car, a flag, a way, and a light. Also, the light object has the light controller script. The light controller script has only one task. When we press the spacebar, it changes the color of the light to green. I will press the spacebar. The only job of this light is to let you know that I pressed the spacebar. As you can see, the car object has no rigid body, only sprite renderer component. First, let's import the Lean Tune package. Go to the Unity Asset Store and search Lean Tune. Here it is. You can use it for free. Click on the Add to My Assets. Go back to Unity and open Package Manager. You can see the Lean Tune package under My Assets. Select the Lean Tune and download it. After the download is complete, import it. The Lean Tune package imported. Let's move this car to the finished flag using the Lean Tune package. Right click on the project panel and create a script. I'm gonna call it Tune Example. Drag and drop the script to the car object. And open the script. First, I'm gonna create a function named Move. And I will call the move function when I press the spacebar. Lean Tune dot. Here, you can see the methods you can use with Lean Tune. You can see here the function you can use to move. I wanna move the car on the x-axis, so I will use this moveX method. As you can see, we need to provide three parameters: the object to be moved, the target position's x position, and the duration within which we wanna to reach the target position. I will create a transform variable to keep the transform of the finish flag. You can directly write the time here, but I will create a variable to set the time from the inspector panel. Save and go back to Unity. Drag and drop the flag object to the target transform slot and set the duration. Start the game. Press the spacebar. As you can see, the car reached the finish flag in 2 seconds. You can set the duration as you want. Let's take a look at the detail of Lean Tune. You can set the type of easing used for the tune with the setEase method. You can specify the ease type you want directly like this. Start the game. As you can see, the car moved back a bit and then moved forward. Also, you can set the ease type from the inspector panel like this. Save and go back to Unity. Select the ease type and start the game. You can try different ease types here. You can delay the start of a tune by using setDelay method. It will start with a 3 seconds delay. Start the game. Press the spacebar. As you can see, the movement started after 3 seconds. We can add a loop to the animation. There are 3 types of loops: once, clamp, and ping pong. Let's take a quick look at the loops. If you wanna set the loop from the inspector panel, you can use the set loop type method. I will create a lean tween type variable named loop type. Go back to Unity. You can easily select the desired loop type from here. You can set the tween to repeat a certain number of times by using the setRepeat method. You can also use lean tween with this syntax format. I'm gonna create a new method named scaleUp. Let's use lean tween to scale the object. This way you can give here the vector of the new scale. Or you can multiply the current scale by 2 instead. I wanna call the scale up function when the move tween is finished. To do that, we can use the setUncomplete method. Save the script and go back to Unity. Start the game. As you can see, the scale of the car has increased after the move is complete. Let's rotate the car after the scale tween is finished. Nice! How we can tween any particular value? We can smoothly bring a float value to the desired number over the desired duration. You can use it in places like health bars or coin counting. In this example, I will smoothly increase the speed variable from 0 to 100. The update speed function will be called every frame, similar to the update function, until the speed value reaches 100. Press the spacebar. As you can see, the speed variable reached 100 in 3 seconds. If you want, you can convert the value to integer like this. If you want, you can assign these values to the variable and change them from the inspector panel. Press the spacebar. You can also make different examples with lean tween. Let's animate UI with lean tween in the next Unity tutorial. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. Thanks for watching. See you in the next Unity tutorial.